Good afternoon, friends. There are two major challenges that I have to encounter. One is to speak to all of you just after the lunch session. An even more daunting challenge is that's what the president and CB told me just now, is to speak on how to build better India, which is inclusive, which is more efficient and all of that, and that too in 20 minutes. I wish by end of the session we can build a better India. So friends, it's a very interesting times for all of us. The president just mentioned a few points. We always say the world is changing. And it's true, everything changing all the time. But change that we are witnessing today are not just the normal changes that you have seen. Particularly in global trade. For a long time, after the initial hiccups, initial apprehensions, initial opposition to WTO, people had accepted the reality that WTO will be an institution through which all issues related to global trade will be handled. And a country, we joined the WTO very late and therefore had to make a lot of concessions to join WTO, is the country which benefited the most from WTO. The country which became the largest producer because they could largest exporter. And all of that happened because of the membership. But today what we are seeing as a change in the world is there is, everybody is questioning what was accepted as a normal thing. We could never expect the countries which swear by capitalism, by market economies, will resort to certain measures which will challenge the entire global trade system itself. And therefore, we are seeing, in a way, a new normal emerging. The so-called settled system is being questioned. And therefore, in that context, we must be ready to not only face the challenge, but also convert that into an opportunity. And I feel, before I come to that, CI could play a very key role into this. Because at the end of the day, the trade will be transacted by the private sector, by the business. And when you trade, how can you trade in something unless you manufacture it? Can a country only be, barring few countries in the world, which are only trading hubs? But essentially, when you want to do something, trade, what you will export is something that you make in India. If you don't make it, how will you export it? And to make it, you must have a strategy. And to make that, there are so many components. What you make, there are so many components. Because unless you make each and every component of the finished product, and then probably you can say that I make everything in my country. There are also connotations to that. I will come to it if time permits at the end of it. But each of this needs a very strategic thinking. And I'm saying why CI should do it is because CI deals with business, deals with private sector, deals with manufacturing, deals with trade, deals with global issues, also knows domestic issues. And therefore, we should try to make CI as a right platform for making strategic thinking on this subject. So I've always maintained that CII should be like a think tank. And you have seen that most of the developed economies have their own think tanks. Whether there are certain state-sponsored think tanks in some of the countries where democracy is not always the form of government, but even countries in Europe, US particularly, there are so many think tanks thinking about so many critical issues outside the government, and that is what makes policy making a much better option. So I think at a time when such challenges are there, you must genuinely think about how do you make this real think tank a reality. Secondly, we'll be a $5 trillion economy. It's a matter of time. And in fact, we could be $10 trillion economy for sure, but rather than thinking a little bit so far away, I am thinking about an immediate future in which we'll be $5 trillion economy. And for a $5 trillion economy, to make it, we need thinking, but to manage it also, we need institutions. And institutions will play a very key role into making sure that we are always on a sustainable growth path. We'll continue to grow, and even if there are certain hiccups, there are some challenges, we can deal with them through having a proper institution in place. And therefore, still more important, that we need a think tank like this outside the government which can actually work with us and not necessarily as an extended arm of the government, which should never happen. Independent, vibrant, efficient, forward-looking, but also participatory understanding the domain issues. And that's what, in this matter of economy, I think CII could be a very important institution and could play that role. While I was saying the challenges, just imagine we are still, despite so many challenges we have faced in the past, even now, today, India is one of the fastest growing large economies of the world, which in itself is not a mean achievement. When people say that there are certain global headwinds, because we were always thinking that tailwinds have come, but even before the pilot could feel tail, he could just look back, he was hit with the headwinds coming in. So in this, despite this, we are really one of the larger, or rather, the growth rate in India is far better as compared to the large economies which are growing. And therefore, we'll go to that $5 trillion sooner. And if you work together, even sooner than what we could have done otherwise. But as I was saying, the global issues. First time after several years, or probably first time in after WTO, people are questioning the entire whole so-called process of globalization itself. What is meant by globalization was virtually accepted in different forms. But everybody is now interpreting globalization in this own manner. What is globalization is something which what suits me at particular time is what globalization is. If it doesn't, I would like to challenge it. And in that context, we have to strategize, and actually speaking, in my opinion, it's a great opportunity for India. If you look at it, we have maintained, thanks to our Prime Minister and his very aggressive, forward-looking foreign policy, we have excellent relationship with major countries in the world. Whether it is North America, whether it is EU, whether it is Far East, whether it is ASEAN, or even the emerging economies, whether it's Africa or Latin America, or even Central Asia. And therefore, we can actually benefit from these so-called challenges to the system by working out a proper, well-laid-out strategy. And to do that, we are actually working on it, and there is not a time to explain to you in detail, but tell you in short, in the last few months itself, we took the initiative on many issues. One, we organized, and this, in fact, some of the venues have been this hotel itself, so I think seems to be it's the right place to call for strategic thinking is the Taj Palace. One, after the collapse in Buenos Aires, I had announced it there itself, we organized a WTO mini shell for 53 countries. You cannot imagine the goodwill that has created globally. Every country was saying, that now nothing is happening, everybody was groping in the dark. And earlier, whenever there was any problem in global agreement, India was always the preferred whipping boy. But this time they said, and WTO DG, Director General, made a public statement that I am grateful to India for taking this bold initiative and bringing so many countries together. So this was one. Second, and again this was here only, that we had all the African countries who came and participated in a program in which now we are trying to work very closely with Africa, because that's in the second block I will put it, in which we like to work with them to even have some sort of an understanding of agreement. And that agreement should be such that when we talk about FTA, we always go to the last point. The ambition we keep as a first starting point, and because of the ambition being so high, many times there are problems in FTA. So I told the Africans, why not we work out in such a way that there will be only benefit front-ended, in which Africans will also feel not threatened, India will also benefit, and we can work out a strategy properly, and slowly we'll move on up the ladder to get what we really would like to get out of it eventually. With EU, again, we have started working with them. In fact, I'm expecting EU to come here in the next few days, and we'll be working with them. With the US, despite the fact that they levied certain, not we are so badly affected, but they have taken certain measures, we are working in a very measured manner, and we are expecting the US Deputy TR to visit India in the next few days' time. We are already working, I don't want to disclose everything, but we work very closely with the administration to ensure that India's interests are properly protected. Thirdly, with China, which is one of our large trading partners, the largest, and we have a huge trade deficit, which is a matter of concern. So I invited the Chinese Commerce Minister, who is very high in the Chinese political hierarchy, very high. He came here, spent 2 days here, 3 days here. And we had an extensive discussion, and they agreed in writing that we must balance the trade over a period of time. And by taking concrete measures, which again is something which is already recorded. So we want to work in a manner that we'll actually take it forward. With ASEAN, when the Prime Minister invited heads of state on 26 January, I invited the Commerce Minister before that, and we had a very long chat with them on this issue. Korea brought in more than 100 of the top business leaders to India, and they said it's the first time such large number has traveled, and they never traveled, even not this number, but even half of them, unless the president was traveling with them. Same with Japan and many countries. So what I'm doing is, we are working out a strategy to work multilaterally through WTO, but also bilaterally with trading blocks and with countries to ensure that we'll be able to get better access to the market and we'll be able to get better exports done from India. And to do that, there are many issues. One, we must be able to produce what can be sold. And the point just now we were discussing with somebody, the point came, is the sellability and scalability must go hand in hand. We must sell because there is a buyer on the other side, otherwise how can you sell? And to sell in such a way that we can actually get the significant share of the market globally, we must scale it up. And therefore, the identification of what could be scalable and what is sellable is a matter of, again, interactive session with all of you. But more importantly, is a proper market research based on what markets we can tap and what products we can sell. So we have already started working on this market research, what product, what markets, how it can be sold, and we are seriously working on it. The second issue, which will be of standards. And I was just going to say that we are trying to make standards for each and every important activity. The ministry is already working on it. More interestingly, in future, and I think we should be conscious of it and start to work on it, is that our service sector will be exporting more, services will be exported more than the merchandise. That's already a global phenomenon. So therefore, when we talk about exports, we must always be conscious of the fact that export would include both services and merchandise, and services will be exported more in numbers, no, more in value than in merchandise. And again, that's a good thing. Because in a way, services produce a lot of jobs. Services, unlike merchandise, do not necessarily the material that goes into product is not exported. So that's another environment and other issues. But point is, we have a great opportunity to do that. And we are responding to this. We have already set aside 5,000 crores for 12 champion sectors, which would be promoted by India. And my ministry has taken it to the cabinet and will make sure that those services sector will grow faster. We are also working on some of the new items of exports, which I said market research. But first, we have created agri-export policy. Because agriculture, what we produce, we already produce 280 million tons of food grains. We already produce 300 million agriculture products, more than 300 million tons of horticulture. So just imagine agriculture and horticulture put together, we are almost close to 600 million. That's a huge quantity that we produce. 30% of fruits and vegetables do not reach the marketplace. They get wasted. So nutrition is not affected, but farmers do not get the income. So if you can export even that partly 30% only, you can imagine the benefit that will accrue to Indian economy. And to do this, again, we can talk coming to the market. I talked to UAE, the Abu Dhabi Investment Authority Chairman, Sheikh Hamed, and me, we are the chairing the session, chairing the forum. And we agreed that we'll actually export it to UAE, to Middle East. Same thing I discussed with the Saudi oil minister, and they are willing to do that. So we are working out on quite a comprehensive strategy action plan to make it happen. On services, which I just mentioned about what we are trying to do, but there are huge opportunities in both each of these segments. But to do that, what we really need to do is to work as partners and try to work together. I think $5 trillion GDP, how is it going to come? We must think about it seriously. I think there is an opportunity to scale up our manufacturing. Otherwise, we'll keep complaining about imports. Imports is something which happens because there is a consumption that is happening in India. If you can produce that much, and then there are issues. How to produce, because how to produce when there is a challenge from import. And that's the strategy you must work out and tell me, we'll work together. And if we can actually produce more, obviously, the imports can also be substituted by making it happen in India. And to do that, we need strategy and we must work together. So I appeal to CI to launch a mission, $1 trillion of manufacturing by the time we reach the $5 trillion economy. Second mission, and all of them we work together, because unless we have the mission, we know exactly what we need to do. And this is not a mission of the government. This is a societal mission. It's a national priority. $3 trillion of services export, services, in which export will also be significant. And therefore, if we make these missions, it really will happen. I'll just tell you in a nutshell, we have to make it happen. First, I'd ask the first day in office as a Minister of Industry and Commerce, I'd ask the DIPB secretary, and he's working on it, to prepare and find out all the regulatory issues which are counterproductive to industry, how they can be removed. And in fact, we are also, CI is probably a member of this, and we are really working on each of the issues to make sure this happens. So secondly, to drive innovation into this, the startups and others. In fact, even on weekend, I was in Mumbai, I called all the venture capitalists. On the other side was regulators like SEBI, CBDT, Ministry of Finance, the Department of the Corporate Affairs, and all of those institutions to only understand why venture capital cannot invest more. Before that, we had a round table with venture capitalists, with the startups, for each sector. And we had taken, I think, 3 or 4 sectors, fintech, healthcare, and oil and gas, wherein we call those startups and say, please tell us how the regulation is not allowing it to happen. Because regulations were made when there was nothing like a startup. Startup is making break with the past, that's why we call it startup. It comes out with new ideas. So if you are going to regulate a new activity with the old mindset, it will never work. So regulation must change along with the change that we want to happen on the ground. And therefore, we had these round tables. So we are working on it. Another thing that we are working on it, is to find out how each and every district becomes a nodal point for growth. If each district GDP, and GDP as measured by services, manufacturing, agriculture, grows by 3% more than the normal, obviously the state GDP will increase, because all the district GDP is a state GDP. And all the 29 states and the 7 union territory GDP is India GDP. So if you start with a district and try to sensitize the district and make it happen, it will actually grow. In fact, tomorrow, I have a meeting on this subject only. We are calling all the relevant stakeholders, and this will actually drive the growth. I will again request the CI to please be partner in this process, in which we are doing two things, not many things in this district, which includes bringing in geographical indicators. And I don't want to expand it for lack of time, but geographical indicators will be another driving force to maintain India's IPRs in various sectors which are happening locally, bring in more economic activity there in the district, but also promote these products globally by putting geographical indicator as a driving force. And therefore, while we do this for the district, I would like you to join. Also, when we talk about ease of doing business, the industrialists face problems not in the central government. When they come to me, I always try to help. Of course, I have another minister better than me can do a better job. But the challenge is not even in the state chief minister. The problem always happens in the district where the action is, whether the land is, whether the labor issues comes up, whether the environment issues comes up. So what we are doing is ease of doing business for each district. And the parameters for that, we have started working on. In fact, we already started working on all the issues that I'm talking about. Because it's my bad habit, start doing first and then tell people. So we are working on each of these issues. And therefore, I am very sure that many of these initiatives will finally converge into making our dream realize of a larger economy than what we are today. And many things, we always feel the problems. Just imagine, and I want to highlight this problem, when we have $5 trillion economy, and thanks to GST and many other measures, our tax to GDP ratio improves. Already we are seeing that the individual taxpayer number has doubled in the last few years' time, already, because of compliance, because of various ways through which we are able to identify them. But that's the direct tax. GST is an indirect tax. Put together is the total tax and where we calculate the tax to GDP ratio. If tax to GDP ratio also improves because of better compliance, and the rate of tax also can come down over a period of time because more and more people will pay taxes, the revenues available with both central and the state government will be much larger than what they are today, and they'll be able to invest more into infrastructure, social sectors, and that again will spur the growth of India. So what I'm saying, eventually, what we really need to put in is make sure that we achieve a reasonably high level of economic growth, and particularly 5 trillion and maybe eventually increasing that, doubling again. That itself will address some of the issues that we face today. And therefore, when we start discussing, obviously, everybody is worried about his day-to-day problems, and he's right. I'm not blaming anybody because that's what is hindering the growth. And while we address them, the only way we can actually reduce the impact of them is by bringing in a higher rate of growth, which can happen with a proper strategic thinking, put in place a proper action plan, and to make that, it's not that only government should make it, but we should do it together. And that's why I'm very excited by the fact that CII has offered to come forward and be the partner to make this a reality. I would like to mention, because I know I'm running out of time, just a last point. There are 115 districts which are the most backward districts of the country. I had a discussion only last week with CI, with the DG CI, Mr. Chandrajit Banerjee, and I requested him, and I make a public request again, that we have 5 different regional councils. Each of the council decides to adopt 5 districts in their individual geographical area. At least 5, you can take 10, whatever number. You can imagine the government is putting in all the efforts. With you all participating and bringing in your managerial expertise into this, we can actually make this district also come up. This again, incidentally, will add to the growth because they are the districts which are not growing as much as the other districts were growing. So when the growth comes into new districts, automatically it adds to the numbers of GDP growth at a national level. So I think there are many of these opportunities. Coming back to it, we are passing through very interesting, challenging, but also very opportune time. If we play our cards properly, and that's what we are trying to do, and we need your support, we can actually benefit from it by creating an opportunity around these issues that are happening globally. We have no choice but to respond in a very positive manner. We cannot say that these issues should not happen. That is beyond our control. That's something which other countries are doing. But what is in our control is the response that we provide, which will benefit our country and try to take us into a little higher growth trajectory. For this, lot of thinking is required at all levels. We are doing our best, but I think it is not sufficient unless both of us join and work together. And therefore, my earnest request to you is that at a CII meeting, when annually you meet, you discuss a lot of issues. This is one issue we must discuss always, is how can India's economy grow better? Growth of India's economy will benefit everybody. It will benefit some people more, some people less, but as you said, making India better with inclusiveness, and that would ensure that everybody benefits, and that's why also introduce the subject of 115 districts. But I think we can make it in this particular way. You could be assured that we'll see a much better taste tomorrow, and tomorrow's better days can be could be possible when we start planning it today and execute even tomorrow. And therefore, let's work together. I really, once again, thank CII for inviting me. I was supposed to come yesterday, but I said, whatever happens, I must come. Because for me, I am your guardian minister. It is my job to ensure that industry and commerce grows, and any problem anybody faces, it's my responsibility. I always take it like this. It may be my weakness, but I take it as my personal problem, and therefore I try to address them, because I feel all the people who are working in India trying to add to economic activity, they are doing a national service, and therefore when they are doing that, problems faced by them is something should be a responsibility of minister like me to address it. So I'll be happy to work with you, looking forward to working with you. Congratulations to you. All the best. Sorry, I forgot to mention one thing, sorry for that. He's on aviation, because I'm also Minister for Aviation. We are working, and she told me to speak about it, so I had forgotten about it. One thing is, we are trying to create a lot of issues. One of the challenges that we are facing in aviation is the growth, 20% and odd, has not created enough capacity, and therefore working on that. One, working on cargo, because at night, when we don't have domestic flights as many, we have a vacant airspace which can be utilized for cargo movement, which can actually ensure that faster and cheaper cargo will happen, because also I'm responsible in my other capacity as a commerce minister. Prime Minister has asked me to look at logistic as a subject, so we are trying to focus on that. Thirdly, more than 1,000 aeroplanes will be required, passenger trains alone, for the next few years. I am again not calculating into this the number of planes required for cargo. And if you manufacture them along with the drones, which will become reality of tomorrow, you can imagine the huge opportunity that will be created and the new ecosystem that get developed, so that make in India and adding to manufacturing, this could be another contributor to this. So I think in brief, with this is something. So I think, Madam President, I adhere to your directive of talking on all issues. Thank you very much.